Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. Today I've got my project pan update for the month of September. Okay, you guys. So I've had project pan updates in the past where I've said, you know, this is a really exciting update. This is a great update. I've even titled some of them like my most exciting update ever, super exciting project pan update. And in those videos, really cool things have happened. Like I've hit pan on a blush. I've finished a blush. I've finished up an item I've been working on for a long time. This update makes those updates look boring. This, I think, is the best update we are going to get in 2020. I have finished so many items just all at once, and I'm really excited to share this with you guys. Some of these I have had finished for a few weeks now, and I've been waiting to be able to share this update to let you know that they're done. So I'm really, really excited to go ahead and hop right on into today's video. So because my project pan is rolling, I always introduce something to replace an item that I've used up. For this particular update, it's actually not gonna be like a one for one. I'm gonna be bringing in a few less items, but stay tuned for the end of the video to see what will be joining the project. I think I'm gonna keep you guys on your toes first. We'll start with some, you know, somewhat exciting updates. This is the blush I've been working on. This is the shade Indecent from Urban Decay. If you remember in our last update, I had very big pan in this, but I decided to go ahead and repress it. I was on the fence, wasn't really sure if I was going to repress this or just continue to use it with the pan in it. But I actually took some photos while repressing this for a little infographic on my Instagram to share with you guys how to repress a product. So if you don't know how, you can always check that out, or I have a video on how to do it that I usually leave in the description box of these videos. Repressing is always kind of funny though, because I always think, oh, I'm about to be done with this, and then I repress it and I'm like, okay, actually there's a ton of product there. And that's how I'm feeling right now. I've been wearing this a lot. I'm wearing it today. I've also been testing out a lot of other blushes for this blush video that I keep talking about. I think it's gonna be the next video that you see on my channel, so stay tuned for that. But feel good about this. I really thought I was gonna hit pan on my Milani bronzer this month, and I feel like that would have just added to the excitement of today's video, but it has not happened yet. However, I think that we're quite close. The rings are becoming very noticeable, and every day when I'm using this, I'm thinking, okay, today I'm gonna hit pan in it. Today I'm gonna hit pan in it. It hasn't happened yet, but I'm kind of thinking maybe in our next update. All right, sticking with powder products, this is an exciting one. This was my powder foundation that I've been working on since, I think, February perhaps, maybe March. This is from Pure Cosmetics. It's their 4-in-1 pressed powder. I just shared the close-up before even mentioning it, but I have used this up, which is very exciting. I really did enjoy this foundation. It's one that I would consider picking up again, especially if it makes its way back into the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty, maybe in the spring sale. The fall sale is going on right now and it's not in there, even though it usually is in the sale. And I was hoping it would be, because I would have repurchased it. No, maybe I wouldn't have. I've got some foundations to work through, but it's tempting to repurchase because I really do like this one and I feel very good to have finished it up. So I actually will be replacing this with another foundation, so stay tuned for that at the end of the video. So this primer looks a little bit different than it did in our last update. I ended up cutting the top off of my primer. This is from First Aid Beauty. It's their Coconut Skin Smoothie Primer. I think this has been in the project since January. This is one that I anticipated using up rather quickly, but that clearly did not happen. It was obviously a full-size tube in the beginning, but we started all the way up here. I had used maybe a third of it, almost half of the product, and slowly but surely we've gotten down to the bottom, and I have now used this up. So you actually saw me cut this open in a video that went up a few weeks ago. It was a video about 5 ways that you might be wasting product. And it kind of falls in line with project panning. So if you missed that video, I'll link it down below. But in that video, you guys watched me cut this open to see how much product was left. There was a lot more than I thought. So I've kind of been scraping the sides, getting every last bit. This one is used up. Now, I debated replacing this with another primer, but because I've had this in for the entire project, I kind of just want to take a break from panning a primer for at least the next month, just have some fun with other primers and not specifically focus on one. But I'm sure I'll bring another primer in shortly, but this month I don't feel like replacing it with a primer. We have also used up this concealer, which is amazing. This is from Too Faced. It is their Born This Way concealer. The shade I used up is Porcelain. I do also own Almond. And I mean, it's so satisfying to look inside that tube and see it fully used up. I'm very excited about this. I thought I would use this up faster than I did, but I'm still excited to have this completed. This is another one that I will be replacing. I do have another concealer that's going to take its place, so I feel really good about that. That is the largest concealer in my collection. It's 0.5 fluid ounces of product, so there's a lot in there. I'm very impressed that I've used it up. That's pretty impressive. All right, this setting spray, you guys know it's been a struggle throughout this project. It is just dripping so much, and I said in the last update, I'm gonna do everything I can in the month of August, and whatever is left on this, it's done. And you know what? Can you hear? There's like a teensy tiny bit left in the bottom, but even today when I was going to use it, I would spray it and more than half of what I was spraying was just like leaking down. There's really not even enough in here for me to transfer it into a different spray bottle, so I'm gonna call this done. I used up a ton of it, you know, started up here. I've gotten great progress out of it. I've gotten great use out of it while I still could, but because of my difficulties with the packaging, this one, we're gonna be done with it. I also debated replacing that one with another setting spray, but I decided again I want to take a little break from setting sprays just for the time being. The e.l.f. Lip Plumping Gloss. Okay, I'm calling this one done. When you see the close-ups, there's still like a tiny bit in the bottom. However, I can't really reach that with this. I mean, the last few times I've been using it, I've been scraping at the sides. And you absolutely could take the stopper out of this to get every last bit of it, but I've decided not to do that. When I've taken stoppers out of lip glosses in the past, it can get a little bit messy. It doesn't bother me as much with the concealer because I'm going to be blending that in, but with the lip gloss, once you have it all down the wand, it's a little bit harder to use than when you pick it up and it's just on the doe foot. And with this one, I feel like I definitely got my money's worth. This was a $5 lip gloss. I feel like I used up 99% of it. I'm not too worried about getting that last tiny bit. Some people would definitely take the stopper out and go ahead and get the last bit of it. Nothing wrong with that. But for me, I feel like, you know what? I've used it up. This is done for me. I'm calling it done. Final update is on the brow pencil. This one is now halfway done. So this is a dual-ended brow pencil and oops, I have used up the side that is kind of like a micro tip. So that side is completed. And now I'm just focusing on the triangular tip. So you guys will go ahead and see the updates. I have used a good amount of this. This has been the main product I've been using recently to do my brows. I've been switching up my brow application a little bit recently. I've been using this for like the outer half of the brow. And then to kind of fill in some little hair-like strokes on the beginning of the brow, I've been using that Essence, no, not Essence, the Ardell Stroke a Brow. Is that what it's called? The brow pen that I shared in my drugstore haul a few weeks ago. So together, I've been really enjoying that combo and it's been a good way for me to get use out of this brow pencil. It's so interesting to me how long that this pencil is lasting in the project. I typically go through brow pencils pretty quickly, but something about the formula of this and the density of it, I'm not really going through it that fast. So while it is an expensive investment, it lasts a long time. So I think that's noteworthy. All right, let's hop into the new additions. I'm really excited to share them. So as I somewhat mentioned earlier in the video, I'm not necessarily replacing every single item. So I'm not bringing in as many items as I have used up at the moment. For me, I feel like a project pan should be very personal and whatever you're feeling like using in the moment is what you should use. There are no rules. And I don't think you ever have to replace items at like a 1-for-1 ratio. So right now I have picked out 3 items that I really want to work on that I've had in mind for a little while now to work on, to bring those into the project. And you know, maybe next month I'll bring in an additional item when I feel like I want to, but right now these are the 3 that really stood out to me when going through my collection. I'm like, you know, what do I think is good for me to add into my project right now? And these 3 stood out. So these are what I'm going with now, but again, I might even add an additional one next month or even 2 if I'm feeling like it. So to replace the concealer, I did go ahead and choose another concealer. This is the Koki Be Bright. This is another one I mentioned in the video about wasting makeup, and you guys saw me taking the stopper out of this. There's hardly any left. This should be a 1 month to complete item. I say that all the time and it never is, but hopefully we can do that with this one. Because there's so little left, there's not really a way for me to mark it. Just know that there's just a little on the sides that I'm gonna work at scraping off in the next couple weeks, and hopefully I can finish this by next month. I did decide to replace the foundation with another foundation. Again, you don't have to do it like this. You could finish up a foundation and then start working on a blush. No rules, but for me, I do want to keep working through foundations, so I chose this one from the brand Undone. I mentioned this as kind of an unofficial project pan item recently. I do not have a lot of this left, and this is a sheer skin tint. So on its own, the coverage is very, very minimal, basically sheer, but I also like it as a mixer, and that's why I think I'll be able to use it up pretty quickly because, you know, on an everyday basis, I like it on its own for a natural look, but I also love the way it mixes in with other foundations. It helps to sheer them out, helps to thin them out a little bit. They look more natural on the skin, so I really love this formula, and I think it'll be fun for me to work on this in the project. I mean, based on how much I have, if this was a different foundation formula, I would anticipate it to last a while. But based on how thin this is and how low the coverage is, I feel like I can use this up in 2 months. That might be a little ambitious. It might end up being more like 3 or 4, but absolutely this will be done before the end of my project, which will end on December 31st. And item number 3 joining the project pan is gonna be this lip gloss. This is from Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is the lip gloss shade Undressed. This is one of the oldest lip products in my collection. Again, it's kind of hard to mark this one because it's not a formula that settles to the bottom. Whereas this e.l.f. lip gloss, you could set it down on its side and it would all settle. With this, not so much, but what I wanna do is just kind of focus on this for a few months until I get to the point where it feels like there's not a lot left. Part of the reason I chose this one is because it definitely can be an everyday shade for me. It's very light, so a lot of times it's just like a center of the lip shade that I'm pairing with a lip liner or a darker lipstick. But I know it's a color that I'll enjoy reaching for every single day, which is kind of how I like to build my project pans. I never want to put in an item that I don't like or that I'm not looking forward to use, because that's when this project starts to feel like a chore, and I never want it to be like that. I like putting in items that I love, like, you know, this Pure Foundation, one of my favorites in my collection, so using it constantly for the last few months has been something that I have looked forward to. Same with this Milani bronzer. It's my favorite, so I love being able to use it every day, and that's how I like to structure my project pans. I never recommend throwing in items that you don't like or you don't want to use. So that's gonna go ahead and complete the most exciting project pan update that I think I have ever filmed. I hope this was just as much fun for you guys as it was for me. Thank you so much for watching. I'll have my full project pan playlist linked down below if you want to check out some more videos like this. And I will go ahead and see you in my next one. Bye.